What is the dumbest thing you did because you were naughty? Story 1. Dated a girl once that did it a few times while driving. She also did it in the office bathroom fairly regularly. Girl just couldn't keep her hands off herself or other dudes D, but that's a story for another day. Story 2. I almost do the thing while driving down the highway once. But then I thought if they found my mangled corpse in the wreck with my hand around my D, my family would be really disappointed, so my brain won that battle. Story 3. When I was a kid, my dad would frequently take me to his job and give me meaningless tasks to help him out. He was a property manager for a secure gov building, federal guards at the doors, etc. Anyways, he had his office in the basement and was left alone down there by everyone else in the building. He would smoke cigarettes down there, blast music, etc. When I was 13, I went with him to work one day and he gave me the job of using an electric sander to take grime off of copper pipes in one of the machine rooms. I was left alone to my task for hours. And about an hour, and I realized how incredibly powerful the vibration was on the sander. One thing led to another, and I ended up grinding the handle of the sander on my D. After I finished, I remember even at 13, saying to myself, "You're really weird, dude, never told anyone till now." Story 4. I was helping my dad close up the sailboat for the winter. We took the seat cushions out, and the long ones had to go in the car between us, kind of stacked up like a wall so we could only see each other's heads. Teenage hormones kicked in on the our ride home, and I proceeded to rub one out while looking out the window. Many moons later, I told my brothers, who then proceeded to tell my dad, "I always wondered why you were so quiet on that trip." Story 5. Decided to do it into a urinal because I was bored and naughty studying for finals when I was in college. I studied in an empty classroom in the creepiest old building on campus so that I could be completely focused and not be distracted. I hadn't seen anybody in that building for 3 hours, so I didn't feel the need to lock the bathroom door or do my business in a stall, like a normal person. So I'm going to town on myself and suddenly the bathroom door opens and I stop during mid-time. Foreskin noises stops suddenly. I just stood there holding my D for a second, put it back in and leave without making eye contact. Still have no idea who that person was, but they definitely knew what I was doing and that I'm f weird. Story 6. Girl offered to make me happy if I let her copy my answers off of one of our finals. I thought it was going to be sometime after, but nope. It was right there during a lecture. Being a typical young guy, of course I wasn't gonna reject the offer. Still surprised to this day we weren't caught. Story 7. Real gamers find a way to get the game to make the controller vibrate. For example, in Star Wars BF2 on the PS2, if you use the clone commander with the infinite ammo cheat and use an elastic band to squeeze down the fire button, you can make it vibrate indefinitely. Don't ask me how I know this information. Story 8. I was talking about this the other day, lol. I once walked 3 miles at 10 a.m. during a snowstorm and -3 degree temperatures. When my girlfriend called and said that her parents were gone for the weekend. The things a naughty 16-year-old kid will do to get laid, lol. Story 9. I called my first grade teacher mom once. It was free time, and I wanted to show her something, so I said, "Oh, mom," and then I caught myself and thought it would be the appropriate time to say, "Oh, mama." Like I was Johnny Bravo. I thought I played it off real cool. Pretty sure my teacher didn't hear me at all, but I died inside for the next hour or so. Story 10. I vaguely remember what happened. I remember I got to choose the bottle maker's mar. We got to share the whole thing. They offered double trouble, so I proceed to strip to that one Hey Kecky Drake song. And for minutes later in my nude, I remember ass in my face and be everywhere. Not sure what else happened. I've tried to Google if this has happened to anyone else. Blah blah blah. I'll never forget what I can remember from that night. I went back upstairs to meet with my buddies. They bailed on me and went back to the Luxor. They said I was down there for 3 hours. WTF did I do? I'll never know. Story 11. Several years back, a woman I had been flirting with called me in the middle of the night one time BC. She wasn't feeling well and asked if I could pick up some medicine and bring it to her place. Went to her place not expecting too much. other than maybe earning some brownie points for dropping off the meds. Anyway, she invites me in and asks if I could spend the night with her. That of course gets me all titillated. However, by the time we get into bed, she's all tired and drowsy despite her best attempt at acting seductive. Next thing I know, I'm lying in bed next to her with my arm pinned under her body while she's snoring away and farting. I end up lying like that for the rest of the night. Got maybe 30 min of sleep that entire night. And of course I then had to get up to work a whole shift in the morning. At least I did earn some brownie points for that BC we ended up dating. For not quite a year afterwards, story 12, went to the bar one night for a beer. I spotted one of my old girlfriends there sitting at a table with a bunch of foreign sailors. She looked like she was tripped out and not all there. I got her up on the dance floor and asked if she was okay. She said she wasn't, so I waltzed her to the fire exit and took her home. I suspected they had slipped a roofie or something in her drink. I sat up by her bed all night to make sure she was okay. She was fine in the morning and remembered enough about the night before that I didn't have to do any explaining. I also had to work after. That part wasn't any fun either. Story 13. Peeped on my sister's best friend showering. I was 12. It's an extremely cringe memory that haunts me when I try to sleep at night. If I'd known the amount of torment it'd cause me in the future, I would have just watched some damn pee. Story 14. Underage. Many years ago, me and my current wife were very little naughty people. We used to go have us under this highway underpass. A little off the beaten path because our parents were always home. Well, it was also near a community center type building. One day when we were walking through the woods to get there, someone thought they seen a man abducting a child. My wife has always been very short. Yes, it was me. We are the same age, just have a crazy height difference. And I have had a beard from a young age, haha. Anyways, long story long, I was getting a blow. And a cop came down to the underpass from the highway up above and yelled, "Freeze." Let me tell you, we both froze. She wouldn't move and had her face covered, with my D still in her mouth. Then the cop just yelled at us, saying, "Can't you guys be doing this at home?" Said he could see I was an underage, and told us about the call. It was the most embarrassing thing to ever happen. We didn't even bring it up again for a few years. Now we are married and it is a funny memory. We even went back there to mess around a year ago. Story 15. Dyed my hair black. My roommate was doing it and the girl helping him was ridiculously hot. She came into the living room and told me, "We have some extra dye. I think you would look hot with black hair." I looked at her in that lime green tube top and said, "That sounds like a great idea." I found out I was allergic to hair dye when, 3 days later, my head swelled up and I looked like that orc general that attacked Minas Tirith in Return of the King with a full head of Elvis black hair. It took a whole month of medication for it to go away as my head was bright red under the hair and secreting a fluid that made my hair hard as a rock. Fun times. Story 16. I had it so bad for this Chinese girl at university back in 2004. And she would not give me the time of day. I did everything I possibly could. Then in a moment of insane desperation and browsing shit, during the earlier days of the internet, I found some sort of self-proclaimed wizard living in California who specialized in love spells. And I shit you not, my 20-year-old brain thought it was a good idea to send said wizard $200 USD to cast the spell. Suffice it to say, the spell did not work. To this day, I still can't believe how stupid I was. Male hormones are ridiculous things. Story 17. Connected with a friend's ex who I knew had feelings for me. Went to catch up over lunch. Ended up spending all day drinking with her. Then F her at the outdoor area of an absolutely packed bar. Neither of us were staying in places. We could have people spend the night, so hired a late hotel room. $$. Get in the door. She immediately vomits all over the room and spent the next 2 hours crying on the floor, saying she loved me while I did my best to clean up. Story 18. I was dating a girl at work, and we would regularly have ass at her side of our business complex. Though she was part of the same company, she was part of a separate regional division and not part of corporate. So her office was typically always empty besides her. One time we were really hot and heavy into it inside the restroom, and against our better judgment we decided it was a good idea. So we did our thing and I blew the biggest, deepest load into her ass imaginable. As I pulled out, there was a fair amount of poop on my D and I walk over to the sink to try and wash it off. As I'm rinsing myself into the sink, we hear the door to our office open and a large group of co-workers walk in. I panic and immediately try to put my D away. And as I drop from my tiptoes, I slam my nut sack up against the wall of the sink and pull my taint skin so hard, I almost buckled in pain. She runs out of the restroom and closes the door behind her and I'm sitting in the dark, on the toilet seat with shit on my D and be hurting contemplating my life choices. Story 19. Drove from Kentucky to Illinois to meet an AOL girl I cybered with. Slept in the back of my pickup truck in front of her house, because I did not think about how her parents would react to that creepy bullshit. Her dad took her on a long drive the next day to pick up furniture or something. I hid in the neighborhood and did not realize it was the alternate entrance to the neighborhood. So when she told her dad I was gone, they drove right by me while I was reading a book in the front seat and we never got together, because he protected her good dad, sad teenager. So then I drove from there to New Jersey for the same reason, and still got nothing. Meanwhile, at that second friend's house, I was AOLing other girls back home in Nevada and one pretended to be a French girl with a crush on me and I angrily outed her for being fake because it did not occur to me. She was just being flirty and playing a weird little nervous energy game. Turned out she wanted to lose her V with me, according to her friend, but now she thinks I'm in bad boy. So I was 0 for 3. Oh boy, being 17 was a confusing time. Story 20. I was freshly out of a relationship with my abusive ex, and I just wanted the first S after him to not mean anything and not be with anyone important, nor anyone I'd meet again. So I went on this anonymous dating site for hookups local to my region and just went with the first, the best person. Off I went to the capital without telling anyone at all where I was going or with whom. We met at a station in the outskirts of a suburb. I got into his car and he took me to a parking lot close to the airport. We had S in the back where he had folded down his back seat and then he drove me back to the main train station. I did some shopping for new underwear, went to a toilet and changed into fresh underwear, freshened up and then took the train back to arrive at church in time for rehearsal in my church. Sure, don't know his name or anything. Couldn't pick him out of a lineup. Super dangerous. I could have been abducted or killed.